Drunkenness is only a plastic pouch and powder away. That's right, the future is here, everybody. Hey everyone, Laci Green here for DNews. Back in my day, if we wanted to get drunk, we had to carry a bottle of booze through the snow, uphill, both ways. But now kids have Palcohol. It's a new and improved way to get drunk that could hit the shelves later this year. Scientists behind the product have turned liquid alcohol into a powder that you can mix with water to make your drink. Their website reports that they have 6 varieties, rum, vodka, and 4 types of cocktails. And last week, the news spread that Palcohol received its federal approval, which caused a mad frenzy, as you might imagine. Then a few days later, the feds were like, oh wait, just kidding, that was a mistake. Palcohol's parent company said that the mistake was related to how much powder comes in the bag and that they're going to resubmit them for approval. It's worth noting that other countries like Japan, the Netherlands, of course, and Germany already have similar products on the market. But how exactly is liquid alcohol turned into a powder? An old patent from the 1970s lets the public in on Palcohol's boozy little secrets. First, they dehydrate a vapor-sorbable carbohydrate base down to a moisture content of less than 1%. Ideally, this carbohydrate powder is one that's easily dissolved in water and perhaps has a little bit of sweetness. Once it's dehydrated to the extreme, the carbohydrate powder is ready to absorb the ethanol. Combine in the proper proportions and voila, you have alcohol in powder form. In order to stay fresh, the powder has to stay in a sealed container, otherwise the ethanol vapors will seep out. Palcohol says that their powders are 58% alcohol by weight, which is why it's also highly flammable. When you mix it with water, the percentage is reduced to 12% though. And FYI, each pouch contains about 80 calories. Is powdered alcohol the great idea that we've all been hoping for? Well, it depends on who you ask. I think for most people, regular liquid booze is probably fine, but it is a solution for people who want to take it on the go without carrying heavy bottles. Think hikers, backpackers, and people who want to slip it in their drink at lunch. And speaking of slipping things in drinks, that's one of my concerns with powdered alcohol. It's actually a little easier to abuse. In fact, the original Palcohol website might be described as wildly irresponsible and completely out of control. Originally, they openly highlighted the fact that you can sneak it into concerts or that even though you shouldn't because that's dangerous, kids, it can be snorted and that it'll get you drunk super fast. Wink, wink. Since the news broke via public records of the approval, Palcohol added a shiny professional new face to their website, which is a smart move. So folks, is this something you might try if it regains its approval? Tell me what you think in the comments. And if you'd like to learn more, check out Anywho's episode on Palcohol, link down below.
They're literally dodging this motion in the hopes of getting drunk like an hour faster. Why? And why would you dodge this motion for this motion?
And don't forget to subscribe for more DNews. Drunkenness is only a plastic patch of padded. That's right. DNews, everybody.